Norman Schwarzkopf, the guiding hand in Desert Storm, died Thursday from complications from pneumonia.
Known as a true patriot and charismatic leader, he leaves behind a very strong Central Florida connection.
WESH 2's Dave McDaniel looks at how he's remembered at Camp Boggy Creek, a camp for seriously ill children.
The video on the Camp Boggy Creek website shows kids at camp, but these aren't just any kids.
My lungs can't open like yours.
I have to get chemo and shots.
Each child faces a medical obstacle, but when they are here, they're just kids.
When they go to Boggy Creek, they're just like everybody else, and they're allowed to be kids. I mean, they can really, really, for that time, be just a normal kid.
I was there 18 years ago when General Schwarzkopf and Paul Newman broke ground on this miraculous place, each putting their celebrity out there for good.
When you're around those kids and you see the terrible suffering that they are going through, and yet you see the love that they share with each other, I come away just rededicating myself to the cause.
Camp Boggy Creek is open to any child with an illness, and they actually go to the camp in groups, meaning they all face the same medical obstacle. So the child swimming or fishing next to you knows exactly what you're up against.
General Schwarzkopf made sure he remained committed to the fundraising over the years so the families don't face any financial burden.
Think of what a great, great world it would be if everybody out there did their own thing. But then there's just one more thing to help someone else. That's what I ask people to do with Boggy Creek. Do your own thing. But do your own thing plus one and make that plus one Boggy Creek.
A man fondly remembered for his battlefield expertise and his strategic genius, but also a man remembered for a heart of gold, obvious when he visited Camp Boggy Creek.
You could see it in his face, and you could see maybe the water in his eyes, and you knew that he felt that this camp was truly one of his greatest accomplishments and something that he was very, very proud of being a part of.
A man with a lasting legacy, filled with fond memories. Dave McDaniel, WESH.